Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the accounts payable or billing side of NetSuite, and specifically generating bills as well as paying them. So let's take a look at this. So here we are on our home dashboard, and the first thing, if we're going to be handling any kind of accounts payable, we're going to want to take a look at our AP aging report. So to do that, first off, understand that if I go up here, you can see that I'm in the controller role. Now, obviously, if you're handling accounts payable, you might be in an accounts payable analyst role. And if you are, these tiles down here, you'd actually have a tile right here that says AP aging. So you'd be able to click on that and go straight to that report. Also, from this role, you can still get there by going to reports, scrolling all the way down to vendors payable, and you'll see we have an AP aging report right here. Now, in this case, I already have it open, so I'm just gonna go up to the tab there. And what we're looking at here is we've got our vendors on the left. We can see all of the open current balances with them. So in other words, any bills that have not yet gone overdue, in this case for 30 days, is all generated here. And then we can see this time period, right? We've got anything that's gone over that 30-day time period, we can see everything here. And then everything that's gone even farther beyond 30 days is listed here, in which case the only thing that's gone beyond 30 days overdue is this one right here from Cable Plus Distributors. And then of course at the end is a full total of the three categories. Now, this is just one example of an AP aging report. You can make it a little more elaborate. You can add additional bands. Right now, we actually, other than the current and the over 30, we actually only have one band technically. I can actually go down to this aging options button and you'll see I've got one band currently selected for 30 days, right, in 30-day increments. I could change it to 15-day increments. I could change it to 3 bands, make it irregular dates, whatever I want, and hit okay on that. And if I refresh this, in this case, I'm gonna add 2 additional bands. So you can see I've got now all of these different bands showing these different time periods, as well as the current on the left and the total on the right. So that's the AP aging summary. And obviously that's gonna be a go-to and one of your most useful resources to be able to see what bills are overdue or over a certain amount that should be tackled first. And it's important to note that if we take a look at this, it is a dynamic report. So if we're, let's say, looking at MicroShop and we wanna click on that value, it brings us to this page, which is also showing us how that value is calculated. So that value was $62,000. We can see all the bills that's making up that $62,000. And we can also click on any one of these bills, and it brings us to the actual bill that's composing that line item. So you can take a look, you can always drill down into these reports to see exactly what's composing these figures. And you could pay the bill right from here if you wanted to. But let's go back to our home dashboard here. And now that we've taken a look at our AP aging report, now what we wanna do is we want to take maybe some purchase orders that we have existing and we wanna create bills off of that. First off, just to kind of reiterate, you might have seen this in an earlier video, but it's important to know and understand the procure to pay process flow. So if you've seen that, it starts with the purchase order and then goes to the item receipt. You've received that good or that service. Then you have the billing, and then there is the payment of the bills. So while that doesn't always go that way, that is the standard procure to pay process flow. So in this case, what we're taking a look at is the beginning of that, which is the purchase order. You can take those purchase orders and develop or create a bill immediately off of those purchase orders. So you do have that ability. So the way you would go about doing that is going up to vendors here. We're gonna go down to purchases. And then if we go over, we'll see bill purchase orders. So if we click on that, basically what we're doing is we're giving the ability to look at the purchase orders and then bill or create that bill off of these purchase orders. So you'll see here, we have a long list of every available purchase order that we could bill. So for example, we've got 2 purchase orders that are related to Dell. Dell is the vendor. And we can see the value for them over here. We've got $300 for this one and another $300 for this one, as well as the currency is shown here. So let's say, and we've got the PO number here, let's say we wanted to create a bill off of this. So we want to maybe group these two things together. So we can click here and here, and we can basically say, okay, out of all these purchase orders, we want to have just one bill for Dell. So we've clicked all the ones that relate to Dell, and we can go down here and we can hit submit. and it brings us to this bill. So now we can go down here and we can see these two. Remember, we selected those two. We can see them both listed here. So one was a monitor and the second one was also a monitor, but for a different date. So we have them both here. And now we can go through the process of actually paying this bill. But before we go too far into that, we're actually going to go back to our home dashboard, just to kind of go back to square zero. So that's how you could create a bill off of a purchase order. But now let's say you just want to pay certain bills. You've looked at your AP aging report and you know there's certain bills you want to pay and you want to go about paying those. So how can you address that? There's actually a few different ways. So one of the most common ways is to go up to vendors, down to accounts payable, and the first item you have there is pay bills. So let's click on that. And it brings us to this page. Now, before I actually get too far into this, I'm going to change. You can see I have the account here. So I'm going to switch this to a particular account. Let's say I'm looking at the US West account. So if I select that, now again, before I go any further in this, I'm actually going to scroll down here and you can see I have a long list of all the bills that relate to that account. So I can just take a look at them. You can see these ones are actually expense reports that need to be paid to various employees. And if I scroll all the way to the bottom here, and so we have these bills down here, which includes, we've got the vendors on this side. So we can see we've got several from Davidson, a couple from cloud computing or consulting. And of course it shows us our currency and the rate, as well as the amount that's due. So this is the original and this is the currently due amount. So in most cases, those are the same. And over here, what we're taking a look at is the left-hand side column. This is basically showing us, and we have the ability to put in any discounts. So let's say, for example, that I want to pay these two bills from Cloud Consulting. By doing that, it automatically notices it takes that figure and it moves it into the amount that's going to be paid. Now I can come in here and I can add a discount if necessary, and it automatically takes that discount off of the amount that you're going to be paying for that bill. So I could select these two and I could hit save and I could go on to the process of paying those bills. But let's say I want to approach it a little differently. Instead of maybe selecting them here on this page, I want to grab the bill itself. So I can click on that date and I can come up here. I've now selected it as control, so it opens it as a separate page. And it opens up that bill itself with the ability to look at all the various things that are happening with it. What's the vendor, the subsidiary, et cetera. What are the various apartment, any kind of classification. I can see it listed out here in association with that. And I then have the ability to come up here with make payment. I can select that. And it gives me the ability to scroll down here. And I now have this bill here that I can select the payment. It already has this one selected. And I also have the ability, because it can recognize that there's another payment associated, another bill that's associated with that vendor. I could also select that other one if I had maybe forgotten about it, and I can select it and pay it in that same payment. So the third way that you could go about doing this is, instead of going through the payment itself, I could go through the vendor. So let's go back to that first page we were on. I have the vendor, which is a hyperlink right here. So let's say I click on Cloud Consulting as a vendor. I've now opened that up as another page. So if I go here, we can see all the vendor information listed out here. And actually, if I go to financial and I scroll down to transactions, it actually shows me a list of all the various payments related to this specific vendor, including which ones have been paid and which ones are still outstanding. And as you'll see, I currently have this one for $300,000 as well as this one for $299,000. Neither of these have actually been paid. So from this record, I could also scroll up to the top here and I could select make payment, and it would bring me to a similar page to make a payment on those two particular bills. But let's go with the second option that we were looking at before, where we went to one specific bill. And so right now we're looking at this bill payment record, and right down here I have this one particular bill, but it also included the second one. So I have the ability to apply both, and I don't want to give any discounts in this case, so I'm fine leaving those as zero, and I have the payments as $299,000 and this bill for $300,000. So I'm going to hit save on that. And you'll see it gives me a confirmation right here at the top that that transaction was correctly saved. So in NetSuite, I already had the vendor's electronic banking information, I've already got that set up with that particular client. So by just clicking that save button, I've now paid those two bills. If you have it set up for maybe payment by checks, those will get printed out by checks. You have all those options available to you on that bill record. So simply by selecting them, hitting save, you've now actually created the journal entries and the payments for those two bills. And that's how bill payments work inside NetSuite. I'll see you in the next video.